have three young children and we go through a lot of bread every week. I'd say that on average, I bake 3 loaves a week. And when we have some leftover bits of the tail end of a loaf that's gone a bit stale, I always try to repurpose it one way or another. And one of my favorite things to do is a baked leng with cherry tomatoes, olives and capers. The people from the coastal towns of the Abruzzo region, where my mum comes from, adore their baked fish. Firstly, because it's healthy, but once it's cooked with olives, tomatoes and salty capers, its aromas are irresistible. So I'm just gonna finish cutting off this bread that will be added to the base of this bake. Okay, so first off, some extra virgin olive oil in a baking dish. Cherry tomatoes go in. It already looks so pretty. And then some capers, which I adore. They're just a little salt bomb. And speaking of salt, this wouldn't be an Italian dish without some anchovies. Italians are obsessed with anchovies. I suppose it's our equivalent of fish sauce. They dissolve into the sauce. They just leave a beautifully rich base and aroma. Okay, and now some olives. And I like to use olives that have not been pitted because they've got more flavor. But this is how I remove the pip. I just squash them and it comes out really easily. Then you release all the oils as well and they go into the sauce and the sauce becomes even more delicious. Now, a little bit of dry white wine, which will cook in the sauce and the alcohol will evaporate in the sauce, but it will still leave the mellow tones of the grapes. Give it a stir. A pinch of salt and some thyme leaves spread out in no particular fashion. But I kid you not, the most amazing thing about this dish is the stale bread. Because, see, we're gonna pop it into the tray and we're gonna just slightly dunk it in the sauce and we're gonna strategically position it so that it's a bit in and it's a bit out. So some bits get a bit mushy and soak up all the sauce and some bits get a bit crunchy on top. It's a big call, but they're better than potatoes. There, I've said it. And this is our base, and it goes in the oven for about 30 minutes, 25 even. It really depends on your oven and how hot it is. You just want to give it a good head start. And then we're going to add the fish on top. So in the oven. Oh, yes, that looks really, really good. Oh, and it smells incredible. I can actually smell every single ingredient that has gone into this base. Now, we are going to add the fish on top. And I am using ling because it's just a beautiful white flesh fish and it's boneless, which makes my life a lot easier. I'm just gonna put it on top, drizzle it with a bit of extra virgin olive oil, pinch of salt, and a little pepper. And this goes back into the oven for however long it takes for the fish to be cooked through. It really depends on the fish that you use, but I'll say this size and this type of fish, somewhere in between maybe 15, 18 minutes. Oh, ecco fatto. Looks so, so good. It smells incredible. And look at all the bits of crunchy bread and all the bits that have soaked up the sauce. And actually, look at this sauce. It is so amazing. And what I love to do is just spoon it on top of the fish. And you know how I added wine when I was creating the base? Now that the alcohol has evaporated, all I can smell is the sweetness that it's left behind. A few more thyme leaves, just pick the baby ones And now we create a bit more flavour, a bit more pepper. And I cannot resist. I actually have to have this piece here, straight from the tray. Look at it. This is the perfect bite because it's got all the soaky bits here and all the crunchy bits here. And for an Italian, this is heaven. Oh. Stale bread, guys. It's amazing.